Monday, Melissa Harris-Perry joined The View for her first TV interview since her fallout with MSNBC, and she compared her exit to a bad breakup.
He hasn't called. Y'all haven't not been out in months. Mm-hmm. And all the places where you used to go together, actually, he's out there with somebody else. And what they wanted me to do was just show up and read the news. And so what I declined to do was that. I didn't decline to come back and do my show. I declined to come back and just
and do the show they wanted you to
yeah.
do.
Did I think it was racialized? Not in the sense of like they're coming after Melissa for being black. Mm-hmm. Do I think it has racial implications? 100%. And here's how I know it. Our show had the most diverse guests on cable news, period. It just is an empirical reality. Taking this show off the air, even if you put me individually back on as a host, meant that the folks who sat at our table, whether they were transgender women of color, whether they were Latino Republicans, they just weren't going to be there anymore because we were the folks who put them on air.
But Whoopi Goldberg pushed Harris-Perry on why she went out the way she did.
Why not wait for the breakup? Why not wait until you're sure? I mean, make your plans. My understanding is they somehow a little bit of your email leaked.
Right.
And somebody said that you then felt instead of just having a little bit out there,
I put the whole thing out there after that. That's right. Well, so I think a couple of things. One was lost trust, but part of it, particularly the part that Joy just read, the little brown bobblehead part, once that's in the New York Times, I mean, I felt like it was really important for people to see the whole argument.
You chose to walk away.
That is correct.
Without severance.
That's correct. Well, because in the end it was either you can have your voice or you can have the money, and I decided to bet on my voice.
Harris-Perry has denied rumors that she's hosting a new show on ABC's Fusion Network or anywhere else, saying she has plenty to do as a college professor at Wake Forest. Brokenhearted fans of Nerdland are anxiously waiting on who will fill the void for a show that was truly one of a kind. For theGrio, I'm Natasha Alford.